Hey everyone, it's Gal here, back with a new tutorial video, and in this video I'm gonna show you how I created this simple animation using the Procreate app and After Effects. I'm gonna start with a drawing, so for this I'm using the Apple Pencil and the iPad Pro. Well, let's open the Procreate app, create a new project, choose the color we want and select the brush we like. I think I'm gonna go with the acrylic brush. I'm starting by drawing the tail and then I'm gonna add a new layer to draw the body. Now we're gonna add some shadow, so let's pick a dark color, choose a different brush. Let's lower the opacity, increase the brush size, and create the shadow. Cool, now I'm gonna switch back to the old brush, create a new layer, and draw the head and the ears. To add some details, I'm picking a bright color and creating a nice spot on the head. Now let's add some shadows here as well, a bit of outline, and some hair. For the face, I choose a dark color, draw a little nose, and create a new layer where I draw the eyes. Now let's add the last layer for the tongue and drag it down below the head. Alright, now we have all the layers ready and we can start making the animation. What I'm gonna do is to export the layers one by one and send them to my laptop to animate them in After Effects. I start with the tail, so I disable all the other layers, including the background layer. I click on the Actions button, choose PNG, and airdropping into my laptop. I'm doing the same for all the other layers. Perfect, now we should have all the layers as separated image files, so let's rename them so we can know which one is what. In After Effects, let's create a new composition. Set the frame rate to 20 and the duration to 10. Now, let's drag in all the files. Let's arrange them, select them all, and move them to the center of our canvas so everything would look nice. Cool, I'm gonna start with the animation of the tail, but before I start, I need to make sure that the anchor point of the tail is exactly where I want it to be. So I hit the Y key on my keyboard and drag the anchor point to the position where the tail connects with the body. Now I'm opening the transform panel, hitting the scale stopwatch and creating two keyframes, one in the beginning of the timeline and one in the middle. On the first keyframe, I'm right-clicking the layer and flipping it. Now, I'm gonna select both keyframes, right-click, and set them as hold keyframes. Cool, now when I hit the spacebar to play, you can see that the tail is rattling, but not enough. So let's add some rotation. I'm creating three keyframes for the rotation of the tail. On the first one, I'm rotating the tail to the left, in the middle one to the right, and in the last one to the left again. Great, now let's continue to the animation of the body. I'm creating three keyframes for the position of the body, I'm holding shift and using the arrow key to move the body right on the first keyframe. On the second keyframe, I'm moving it left and in the last one to the right again. Now let's select all the keyframes, hit a right click, add easy ease and see how it looks. Okay, perfect, now the next step is to animate the head. As I've done before, I'm moving the anchor point to the middle of the head and creating three keyframes for the rotation. Now, before we change anything, we want to make sure we link the eyes and the tongue with the head. So I'm selecting these two layers and dragging that little spiral icon over the head layer. Now in the first keyframe, I'm gonna rotate the head by 10 degrees to the left, in the middle keyframe to the right, and in the last keyframe to the left again. Selecting all keyframes, adding easy ease, and we have the head moving and the other layers linked to it. Now what we're going to do is a bit complicated. We're going to unsync the rotation of the head from all the other moving parts, so it would look like the tongue is rattling and that the head is kind of leading the movement. What we got to do first is to select the rotation keyframes of the head layer, hit Command C to copy them, and we're gonna paste them in the tongue layer so that the tongue layer would also be rattling. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to the head layer and copy the middle keyframe. I'm holding the Command key on my keyboard, hitting the right arrow key 10 times to move 10 frames forward. And now I'm clicking Command V to paste the keyframe. We're not seeing anything, but that's okay, we basically just added a keyframe outside of the timeline. Now we can click the rotation to select all the keyframes and we drag them a bit to the left, so they will be unsynced with all the keyframes of the other layers. Now you can see that the head movement is a bit more independent and that it leads the animation. Cool, now let's finish by trimming the beginning of the eyes layer, so it would look like the puppy is blinking. Let's also select all the layers, turn on the motion blur effect, and we're done. Well, thank you so much for watching this video, I hope everything was clear. Please hit the like button if you enjoyed it, and make sure you subscribe to my channel so you will see my upcoming videos.